Forte says, now we can travel the cave safely. That's right, says McBean. Alright, let's go back to Dogarna. Not yet, we gotta... Don't teleport us out of here. Alto says, Viscount Eagle will be relieved. No, I wasn't done exploring the cave. McBean says, we killed the monster in the cave path. People can travel safely to and from Envorin now. Really? You did a great job. We can't
thank you enough.
Forte says, although we killed the big guy in the cave path, we can't possibly get rid of all the other small ones showing up along the road. The problem is not entirely gone yet. McBean says, I hope the Pensola soldiers will be back soon, otherwise more monsters as powerful as the one we just killed may settle in.
Right. Guarding the roads is important. We must act quickly.
Anyway, we're happy to have been of some help.
I can't let you go without properly thanking you.
Then thank us.
Parker, prepare a meal.
Please, allow me to show my appreciation.
Oh, thank you, says McBean. Your gesture means a lot to us already. You already gave us a wonderful gift, Leon's Resonance Stone. We can't receive anything more. After all, we are troubadours. We must get to Envorin as soon as possible and make some money. We won't feel at ease until then.
Well, maybe he can just give us money.
So I see you have an artist's blood in you. That reminds me of the musical audition held at the party on Viotam Island. If I had been invited to the party, I could have nominated you to take part in the audition.
Una says, well, we've actually been nominated already. Forte says, we were planning on to enter the audition. However, now that we know people are suffering because of the party, we don't feel right going there. McBean says, not necessarily. It is the Duke of Pensola who is responsible for what's happening in his country. After all, it was the Duke of Pensola who sent the guardsmen to the party. What kind of person Rish is an entirely different matter.
I see your point.
Well, I might have said too much. Of course, we don't know anything about the situation the country is in. It's not my place as a traveler to meddle with the governing of a country. Forte says, but don't you think we should at least meet the Duke? Why? Asks Una. Since the Viscount had Leon's Resonance Stone, the Duke may have one himself. It seems there's a Resonance Stone in Envorin to begin with. Envorin, whatever. Una says, there's a chance the Duke has it.
That's too easy, says McBean. It's possible. The Duke is also the ruler of the town. He may have some clue at least. Please wait here.
What are you doing out of bed? Viscount. Take it easy, says McBean.
I'm fine. Thanks to you, the monster is gone. The psychological relief made me feel much better physically.
Okay. He doubles as his own therapist, you know. He's about to fall down.
Unk.
Viscount Igul drew up a letter.
Give this letter to the gatekeepers at the castle, and they'll take you to the Duke.
Forte and his friends receive a Viscount's letter.
This is the least I can do.
Castle. Castle here? Or barracks, whatever he said? Thank you, says McBean. It will help us a great deal.
By the way, can you deliver this letter for me too?
Forte and his friends receive a letter to the Duke. A letter to the Duke, says Forte.
It's a report about this monster incident. I hope after reading it, the Duke will understand the situation correctly.
That's no problem, says McBean. We'll deliver it without fail.
Thank you.
So long, then.
The Duke leaves in Castle Envorin. The castle is massive, so you can't miss it.
Thank you for everything. Please see to the letter from the master.
We will. Let's see to it right now.
Where's Hunter Book 1?
Letter written by Viscount Igul must be delivered to Duke Pensola.
Oh, he's a Duke Pensola.
introductory letter written by Viscount Eagle. You can see Duke Pensola with it. See him with it. I mean, you can see it written there. Oh, another scene here. Uto yelling, Forte! What happened to the monster in the cave? Did you avenge the Viscount? We can avenge the Viscount. He's not dead. I mean, as far as I know. I've only seen avenge when somebody's died. Yeah, says Forte. We killed the monster in the cave. That's great. Hee-haw. Okay. I was scolded by my father for having gone to the cave, but I feel good now. Thank you. Bye. Yes, that conversation's over. You know what we need? Some more of these, restore snuffs. Yep, I'm sure. And we'll exchange while we're here. Any new weapons since we've been gone? Probably not. So when we get to Envorin, what's his name is leaving us? Altos. Alright, let's see what people have to say. And then I guess we gotta travel through that cave to get there. I definitely want to get back to the cave and explore it. That monster is said to have been exterminated. I was actually concerned, so I'm relieved. By the way, who exterminated the monster? There were four of them. The Viscount is wounded and cannot move. You have a lot of points in your conversation. I know you exterminated the monster. I thank you on behalf of the Pensola Army. We truly appreciate your brave deed. Once the soldiers return from Miotam Island, everything will be alright. You seem rather optimistic. Life hasn't crushed you down yet enough. Uto can't go out of Dogarna now. I don't feel sorry for him because he brought this upon himself. But then again, I think better of him now than he did before. He was kind of cool. Oh, someone I just talked to. Forte, the monster was scary, wasn't it? My father told me not to go to the road for a while, but I'll sneak out of the house soon. Okay. Don't get yourself killed. Let's visit the senior citizens here. They say prices are soaring in Envorin and making the lives of people difficult. That's all because someone called Rich is buying up all food for his party. I hope the Duke will learn from the Viscount a little. I hope. Ever since Rich came here, Pensola has become so beautiful, I can hardly recognize my country. The town of Envorin in the north has grown past Bozerl in the neighboring country. Pensola is a small country without much reserves or resources. I wonder where the seed money is coming from. Prosperity built on deceit will not last long. Bad things will happen soon. See, this guy has more of a grip on reality. Bad things will happen soon, indeed. Only a matter of time. Thank you for saving my son from danger. I'll keep him from the road for a while. To tell you the truth, I'm a bit happy. I found such a strong adventurous spirit in my crybaby son.
Well, this means he's brave and empathetic, right? Unless he's just crying for himself. I mean, I don't know. They say the monster along the road was exterminated. I can leave now.
Okay, donk-donk-donk-donk-donk-donk. I wonder if Viscount Igor will attend the party. Personally, I don't care about the audition, though.
Good, then we don't have to compete against you. You're the ones who avenged the Viscount. You're so cool. McBain laughs, says it wasn't that difficult.
You're cool, but the Viscount is 100 times cooler than you.
McBain didn't like that very much.
It looks like the monster in the cave path was exterminated. I'm relieved. You can walk the road safely now.
Relieved.
By the way, Dogarna underwent a major facelift some years back, and old passages are left in some parts of the town. They say treasures are left in some of these passages. If you're interested, you might want to take a look. Do they have a secret thing after all? Yeah, treasure. Hell to the yeah. Is it where I thought it was? What are these passages? I'm looking for them.
Whoa! There we go. Haha! Cool. Thanks for the heads up. I would have missed that. Where exactly is this okay, chest? Oh, Doll Knight 7. Nice. Does it continue on? Looks like it just comes up there. Okay. Well, he said passages, so we will look some more. Maybe that's it. Oh, wait, there we go. Thank you. Dead end, though. Huh. Whoa. Hey, hey. Chest. I have a hard time seeing where I am. Okay. A spare key. Universal key that can open common doors. Don't use it with bad purposes. Really? Don't use it with bad purposes. Well, the purpose I'm going to use it for is to get to places that are locked and I want to get into. If that's bad purposes, then so be it. Alright, now I'm going to have trouble finding my way back. Oh, we came out here. Holy crap. Ugh. Yeah, I'm not overly fond of this. I need, like, a square, like, or outline or something so we can tell where our character is. I can't find my way back. Wait a second. See, I know we were traveling from north, and I'm trying to go there. Wait. Oh, it's on the side there. I have to go all the way up. Oh, well, there we are. Alright, now we're gonna head back and I wanna check out this cave. She was so rudely interrupted. There was a bridge and all this stuff. And I wanted to see what was there. He wanted to attack us and then change his mind at the last minute. Or it. Get up there. Fork is a part of the song we don't often hear because we're usually interrupted by a monster. I like it. Back here. Now the monsters we had seen. Well, this was a dead end, right? Yeah. was on this side, but not more. Right in here. That's where we fought them monsters. That's right. Do you have another secret thing? Oh. Sort of. Leash bottle L. Ooh, a large one. This is our first one we found. Drink that fully restores magic points contained in a large bottle. So that looks like goes to a separate area. Itch. Oh, dead end. Seen that. Now here's his bridge. Well, it's just a dead end anyway. Alright. Oops, it's the other one. Eleven puzzle. Okay, I guess that's a rock wall there. Look at that thing. Huh. It's afraid of us. I'm not crazy about it either. Well, there's those poo-poo things, whatever. Poopiro. Okay, we go north. What's over here? A chest, yay! Mirage mail. Some kind of armor? Or a fake letter, either one. Armor generating a shimmer of hot air. It blocks physical attacks for a while. Hmm. Who could use this? Defense goes down. Avoidance goes up. I'll give it to Una. Did I look over here? I forgot. Yeah, I did. Someone knocked his block off. Well, now you want to hunt us. Okay, there's a lot here. Okay, we leave through the north. Let's look around the rest of the area. Who's that octopus monster? Okay. That's what I was looking for. A call bell. What is that? Huh? I don't think I looked at the fresh bread we got when we left that one town. Soft golden bread, take a mouthful and your HP will be restored completely. That's awesome. That spare key is cool. I want to get a skeleton key. I don't know what this bell is. Oh. Bell that makes a good sound. Monsters like it and encounter rate increases. Alright. I don't need that just yet. Oops. Alright, we'll leave. We'll leave out the north way. He squished himself. He's like, we're trying to get past you. I'll just squish over here. Envorin. Forte says, so this is Envorin of the Principality of Pensola. It's huge. And it's beautiful too, says Una. Alto says, was it so beautiful before? I came around here 3 years ago. I don't know how to say this, but it's too beautiful compared to the city I remember. McBain says, I came here around 10 years ago myself. I agree with you. It's a completely different city. Forte says, what's wrong with being beautiful? Una says, which way is the castle? McBain says, from here you should go straight to north. Well, before we do that, let me read these last two doll knights. I don't know if I've been reading them. I know I'm making videos of them, but I'm not putting the videos up until we have all the volumes. But we'll finish off with doll knight 5 and 6. The girl with sky blue eyes. Oh no, I read that, right? I made a video of it. Hopefully I read it here in the series, I'm not sure. Doll Knight 6, The Worry of the Princess. Doll Knight Volume 6, The Worry of the Princess. Could you please protect me for 2 weeks until the coronation ceremony is over? It was inside the royal chamber at the palace that Princess Tia made this request with a serious face. Of course, she was addressing the Blue Knight, not Pedro. I do not deserve such a task, Your Highness. You must have more suitable knights in your escort force. Pedro, who had lost the opportunity to tell the princess that the Blue Knight was a doll, had escorted her all the way to the palace and was shivering in anticipation of further trouble. The knights in the escort force that is protecting the capital are all controlled by my uncle, Duke Gaston. In fact, they had deserted me when I was attacked. There are indeed numerous rumors about Duke Gaston, all of them unfavorable. Yeah, we know about Gaston. Everyone knew that he was amassing personal fortunes while the former king was ill. The man in black you had chased away, Pedro. I'm sure he was my uncle's aide. Everything was his plan. The blue eyes of Princess Tia became clouded. Looking at her saddened eyes, there was no way good-natured Pedro could say no to the princess's appeal to have him as her escort. Now that I know the situation, it will be my honor to serve you. That's great. Thank you very much. The princess smiled a bright, cheerful smile.
She must have been so relieved she even smiled at Pedro. Pedro, who was pretending to be the servant, looked at the slightly rosy cheeks of the princess. I thank you too, servant. By the way, what is your name?
I have no name that is worthy of your attention, your highness.
Pedro pulled his cap down over his eyes. To be continued.
We'll continue it right now.
Dull Night, Volume 7, Not So Peaceful Days. Being the princess's escort was a much more difficult job than Pedro had expected. Day after day, rogues were sent to attack the princess. Because the princess was close to Pedro in age, she began talking to Pedro in a friendly way. Pedro was happy to win the princess's trust, but at the same time, he was nervous. Nervous about what would happen if the princess found out about who the Blue Knight really was. In the meantime, a letter from Pedro arrived at the doll workshop outside the capital. What is he doing? After grasping a rough idea about what was going on from the often blurry text, Capuri smiled bitterly and sighed. Well, but this may be a good opportunity. Pedro was a cheerful, honest young man whose mind was occupied by his dolls. Living outside the capital, he didn't have close friends. Probably because of his infatuation with dolls, Pedro didn't seem to be lonely. Capuri knew that serving as the princess's escort was an august task, probably above Pedro. However, Capuri hoped that Pedro would learn human compassion through this experience. It was the kind of love a father would have for his son. To be continued. Thank you for listening to Let's Read.
Oh my god, I thought I was reading a book there for a second. Thank you so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.